Dignity is a current issue that has recently caused controversy because of a young woman who chose to die with dignity. The 29-year-old Brittany Maynard was diagnosed New Year's Day after suffering debilitating headaches for months. She fought back her brain tumor with two surgeries, hoping she would beat it. But unfortunately, a couple months later, she learned her brain tumor had returned more aggressively. The treatment recommended for Brittany was whole brain radiation, which would singe off her hair, cover her scalp with first-degree burns, and her life would be gone. Brittany considered going into a hospice care, but chose not to do so because of the fact that she could have suffered for weeks or even months, but chose not to do so because she didn't want her family to see her that way. She then researched Death with Dignity, which would enable her to request a prescription from her physician that she could self-ingest to end her life if her tumor became more unbearable. But Brittany may have to make a lot of changes to get this done. She established residency in Portland, found a new physician, a new home, a new driver's license, had to change her voter registration, and her husband had to take a leave of absence. But in Brittany's case, she was lucky to be so flexible and have the resources and time to make all the changes to be able to die with dignity. Most families are unable to pick up all their belongings and move to another state while paying for medical costs. If someone is suffering with their medical condition and they do not live in the six states that allow them to die with dignity, they will most likely suffer until their last day of life. On November 1st, Brittany decided it was time for her to die with dignity. Brittany was a strong young woman, and she was not suicidal. She just did not want to continue her life with cancer. According to Forbes, terminally ill patients do not want to die, but are facing an imminent death most after long efforts to cure their illness and heroic efforts to palliate symptoms. Despite excellent pain and symptom management, some find the dying process unbearable and want to achieve a peaceful death. Terminally ill people do not have the ability to reduce their suffering enough. A lot of the times, medicine isn't the solution to the patient's problem. In Brittany's case, she could have lived a couple months longer if she had admitted herself into hospice care. Hospice is a home providing care for sick, especially the terminally ill. But Brittany knew hospice care was not for her because she would have been given morphine, a drug used to relieve moderate to severe pain. It works in the brain to change how your body feels in response to pain. According to WebMD, morphine has many side effects like abnormally low blood pressure, dizziness, drowsiness, excessive sweating, feel and be nauseous, faint, incomplete or infrequent bowel movements, and the patient would have an induced, relaxed, ease state. Hospice can also be mentally draining for not only the patient, but for also the family of the patient. Another reason to legalize death with dignity is, according to AboutHealth.com, patients have a better chance of experiencing a painless and less traumatic death. Whereas if they would wait until their illness worsens, they would suffer. Legalizing death with dignity would help in alleviating the patient's suffering of their terminal illness. It would be unfair and inhumane to allow them to stand the intolerable pain. According to Barbara Coombs Lee from the Compassion and Choices, she states that hospice care is a gold standard. It's wonderful, but it's not a miracle. And it can prevent the kind of relentless, dehumanizing, horrific decline that Brittany faces, where her disease will cause her unending seizures, headaches, nausea, vomiting, and pressure in her brain, and the loss of every bodily function, including thinking and moving. Terminally ill people do not have the choice to end their suffering. In most cases, a lot of patients, like Brittany, do not want their family to remember them suffering during their last days on Earth. According to Barbara Lee, Brittany's family did not have to watch her seizures or stand beside her for weeks on end while she was in a semi-comatose state and dying very slowly. But if patients decide to go into hospice care, according to livestrong.com, when a family chooses to put their loved one in hospice care, they must come to terms with the fact that the individual is going to die, usually in around 6 months. The struggle of having to see the individual dying without hope of recourse can be emotionally draining. This strain can be compounded by the emotional grief of having to care for the individual. But hospice care is not for most, because the patients have already tried everything. In a letter to Sacramento Bee, Louis Schaefer, who also struggles with his terminal illness, says, "Portraying me as a suicidal is not disrespectful, is disrespectful and hurtful to me and my loved ones. It adds insult to injury by dismissing all that I have already endured. The failed attempts for a cure, the progressive decline in my physical state, and the anguish which has involved exhaustive reflection and contemplation leading me to this very personal and intimate decision about my own life and how I would like to end it. There is a growing demand for dying with dignity legislation. A lot of patients feel that after a diagnosis similar to Brittany's, they have lost control of their life. Jennifer Glass has been living with lung cancer for 2 years, and she was told by her doctor she has a 5% chance of surviving the next 5 years. After Jennifer heard Brittany's story, she says that she has yet come to Brittany's state, where Brittany's stage was in. But she hopes that in the next few years, California adopts the Death with Dignity Act because she wants to be able to control the decision about ending her own life. In a video posted online by Jennifer, she states, "The only control I have is how that happens, and I want to control that for myself." Brittany was unable to move to another, was able to move to another state and be able to die with dignity. But 44 states have yet passed the legislation. Death with dignity is a fundamental human right. People who do not have to live in pain or drug debt would rather end their suffering, and not for not only themselves but for their families. Death with dignity is a more humane suicide option. Terminally ill patients who do not live in the 6 states have no choice other than to commit suicide. Craig Skolfergen struggled with neurofibromatosis, a tumor formed on the nerve cell, frequently symptomless but occasionally malignant, which forms throughout the body. He has undergone several surgery procedures throughout his 28 years of fighting it. And through the, though another surgery seemed unbearable, since the Death with Dignity Act was not yet passed in his state, he instead took matters into his own hands. One night, he took 12 sleeping pills, put 2 plastic bags over his head with elastic bands, and he passed away. Craig wanted to end his life surrounded by his family and listening to his favorite music, but because the legislation was not passed, he was unable to do so.